Hello everyone. Today in this video we are starting with the chapter of linear equations in one variable. Before getting into the depth of this subject content, first we need to know some preliminary informations. That means some basic things we need to know here. First of all, if you observe the first point, what is said here? An algebraic equation is an equality involving variables. Please look at the first line. An algebraic equation is an equality involving variables. Now, what does these terms equality and variable mean? Let us check here. What is said here? It has an equality sign. That means an equation, an algebraic equation must always have a sign of equality. That means we should understand that where there is equation, there should be sign of equality. After that, the expression on the left hand side of the equality sign is the left hand side, that is LHS. That means in an equation, the expression present on the left hand side of an equation is known to be left hand side, and in short it is known to be LHS. After that, the expression on the right side of the equality sign is called as right hand side. That means the expression which is present on the right hand side of the equality sign is known to be the right hand side, and in a short form it is known as RHS. Now let us understand the parts of an equation with the help of this example. An example is set here, that is what? Twice x minus 3 equals to 7. This is the equation for as example I am considering here. Now look at each and every part, particularly the highlighted parts of this equation. The entire expression is known to be an equation. After that, this is the sign of equality. Without this sign of equality, there is no existence of equation. This is well understood. Again, coming to the extreme left of the expression, I mean on the left hand side, the first term present is twice x. Now what is this x? This x is nothing but the variable. Variable means what? An unknown term. Unknown term whose value is to be determined. Let us look at the second point now. In an equation, the values of the expression, please look at the highlighted parts at the top of this page. The values of the expression on the LHS are always equal to those on right hand side. We already have considered an example. Let us have a look on it once. Twice x plus 3. Twice x minus 3 is equal to 7 was the expression. I mean equation. Now in this case, this is the sign of equality. It is said that the values of the expressions on the left hand side are always equal to those on right hand side. From this line itself, it is well understood that the expression what is present on left hand side must be equal to the term present on right hand side. That is the only one way to imply the fact that the sign of equality, I mean this entire equation, existence of this equation is valid. After that, what is said? The equality is possible only for certain values of the variable. The equality is possible only for certain values of the variable. These values of the variable are the solutions of the equation. What is said here? The equality is possible only for certain values of the variable. Let us see in what way. our the equation which we have already considered is 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. Now in this case, this entire expression, I mean the entire equation, will be valid for certain value of x. Now what is that value of x? That we can find out only by solving this equation. The values of the variable are known as solutions of the equation. Solution means what? I told you that while considering the equality of the terms present in the equation 2x minus 3 equals to 7, it is said that the equality will be valid only for certain value of x. Till now, we do not know any value for x. That is why it is considered as variable. That means an unknown term. When we shall know the value of this term x, it will be something like, means we should get such a term by putting that value in place of x, we shall be getting some result which is already present on the right hand side. This specific single value of x is known to be solution of this equation. Let us consider an example. We consider the previous equation only, and that is 2x minus 3 equals to 7. In this case, suppose for the time being we are considering value of x as 5. Now let us check whether for this value of x this equation exists or not. So we should start with the LHS, because the variable is present only on the LHS. So the LHS is 2x minus 3. So in place of x here, I put 5. When I put 5 here in place of x, I got 2 into 5 minus 3. 2 into 5 minus 3, that will give us 10 minus 3, and the result is 7. Now, when we check the right hand side of this equation, we find that 7 is already present. That means whatever value we are getting from LHS, that is 7, is already present on the right hand side. Therefore, it is very clear that for x equals to 5, this equation 2x minus 3 equals to 7 will be valid, will be satisfied. Okay, now coming to another value of x, when we consider x is equal to 8, suppose for the time being I consider that x is equal to 8, and let us check whether LHS is equal to RHS or not. If I get that LHS is equal to RHS, then it will be very clear that for x equals to 8, this equation, I mean equality condition, will be satisfied. Let us check. In the LHS, in place of x, I have put 8 here. After putting 8, the result comes as 2 into 8 minus 3. 2 into 8 will be giving you the result 16. And 16 minus 3 will be equal to 13. Now, it is very obvious that when you check the right-hand side, we find the number 7. But the result from LHS for x equals to 8 here, I'm getting as 13. 13 cannot be equal to 7, yes or no? That is why LHS is not equal to RHS. What does it mean? The equality condition of equality of this equation is not satisfied. Therefore, we can conclude that x equals to 8 is not a solution here. Coming to the third point. In the third point, what is said? How to find the solutions of an equation. This is the most important part, not only for the first exercise but also for the entire chapter. If you do not know this part, you will not be able to get the answers of all the questions under this chapter exercises. Okay, let us first notice the first point, what is said under the heading, how to find the solutions of an equation. The first point is given here to be the two sides of the equation are considered to be balanced. That means what is meant to say here is what? Twice x minus 3 is equal to 7. Initially, this example only we had been taking. So in this case, in this particular equation, we must have to consider that LHS is already equal to RHS. That means whatever value we shall be getting for LHS, that must be already equal to RHS. What does it mean? When this equality is satisfied, that is why this is an equation. Okay, and when this is an equation, it must be understood that LHS and RHS are already balanced. Okay, now moving on to an example. The previous example only again we are taking. Let us proceed with an example. The previous example only we are considering here. Twice x minus 3 is equal to 7. How to solve it? Okay, before we come to this example, the second point we further have to discuss. The second point is to perform the same mathematical operations on both the sides of an equation so that the balance is not disturbed. What does it actually mean? Suppose this is the equation, the marked part is the example I'm taking. Twice x minus 3 is equal to 7. Suppose for solving this equation, you must have to add 3. You want to add 3 on both the sides. Suppose not both the sides, only on one side you want to add it. Say twice x minus 3 plus 3. I have already added 3 here. Is equal to 7. Do you think it is valid? Of course not, because when on one side you are adding 3, the RHS and LHS both will be imbalanced. Whatever operation you are carrying on the left hand side, the same thing should be carried out on the right hand side also. That means, in other words, if you are adding 3 on the LHS, you must have to add the same figure on the right hand side. That is, twice x minus 3 plus 3 will be equal to 7 plus 3. Again, suppose you want to subtract 3 from the LHS. If I write like this, twice x minus 3 minus 3 is equal to 7. Again, in this case, the same thing is not balanced. The equality is not satisfied here. That is why, if you are subtracting 3 from the LHS, the same thing should be subtracted from the right hand side also. Then only the equality will be maintained. So addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, these are the four operations to be carried out in an equation. So whatever operation you carry out on one side, the same thing should be done for the other side also. That means at the same time, both the sides should be involved. Now let us proceed with this example. The equation, again the same equation I am taking here, twice x minus 3 equals to 7. Suppose we want to solve this. Okay, it is already mentioned here. Let us solve twice x minus 3 equals to 7. How to solve? So in this case, in case of this equation, two steps we have to follow. You can already see the highlighted parts. Step 1. In step 1, what is said? Adding 3 to both the sides. Why there is a necessity of adding 3 to both the sides? There is one kind of necessity, that is what? We always should keep in our mind that the term containing variable should always be kept alone in one side. That means here on the left hand side, the term containing the variable x is twice x. Our intention is to make twice x independent of all the terms associated with it. And for that, actually minus 3 was initially associated with twice x. So to remove this minus 3, there is only one way out in our hand, and that is what? On both the sides, we have to add 3. When we add 3 on both the sides, minus 3 and plus 3 on the left hand side will be getting cancelled, while on the other side 3 will be getting added with 7, resulting into twice x equals to 10. This is the result, twice x equals to 10. Just as side note, I have given here the balance is not disturbed. Already it is told to you that if you carry one kind of operation in one side of an equation, the same thing should be carried out on the other side also. That is why here 3 is added to both the sides so that the balance, that means the equality of the equation, is not disturbed. So ultimately we got this step, twice x equals to 10. Coming to step 2. Now from first step, what was left behind? Twice x equals to 10. Our intention is to get value of x. That means we should keep in our mind one thing, that the variable x should be made independent of the rest of the terms associated with it. So in the previous step, already we got twice x equals to 10. There is only one term 2 associated with x, yes or no? That means 2 is multiplied to x. We have to remove this 2 from x. There is only one way out in our hand, and that is what? Dividing both sides by 2. So when we divide both the sides by 2, if you notice the LHS, 2 divided by 2, 2 will be getting cancelled, and only x will be left behind. And on the right hand side, 10 by 2 will give you the result 5. And so x equals to 5 we got. Therefore, the required solution is x equals to 5. You can notice that on LHS, only x is left behind, while on RHS, 5 is left. So that's all. The required equation is, the required solution is x equals to 5. So that's all about the preliminary informations for this exercise 2.1. Before starting with 2.1, you need to know these basic things, especially how to solve a linear equation in one variable, then what is equation, how condition of equality is satisfied. These things you need to know, and already I have explained these things in this video. Please go through. In the next video, we shall start with the second 2.1 exercise, 2.1 second chapter, first exercise. Thank you all.